because definitely not the best beginning to a vlog, but whatever. Taking out my trash right now before we start this episode. But I feel like it's gonna be super, super, super cool. Alright, I'm back out. Beautiful day. Ooh, this package for me? I don't know, let's see. Maybe or may not be. No, it's not mine. So, out here going for my morning walk. Usually do a run too, but for the sake of this vlog, I'm doing a morning walk. But episode one, this episode is really going to define like everything throughout this entire journey of me building this agency, because this episode right here is pretty much we gonna go over like who I want to be before I start anything. Like, I really want to get laser focused on who I want to be as a person, as a business person, what I want this business to be, what I want it to become. And I feel like, and when I say as a person, I mean literally everything, like health, family, money, insecurities, like literally everything, man, like all of it. And I feel like once I really define who I am and who I want to be as a person, then I'll be able to effectively like guide all my decisions that I make, like in this business that I'm building. So like that's really what this episode of this vlog is about to be all about, man. Fucking street over here. It's literally taking forever. I'm about to continue my speech. My street. But yeah, like this episode one is just defining who I want to be, man, and getting that all the way correct so my vision to be in place before I do anything else. So, you know, once I get back to the crib, we're gonna start this whole thing up, and I'm just gonna run down like who I want to be. And you know, things may get personal also, like, but I don't know. I feel like this portion right here just help out a lot of people, man. And I feel like a lot of people don't really define this in the beginning. And I feel like, yeah. And that's pretty much it. So I'll meet y'all back at the crib, and then we're gonna go over who I wanna be. Yeah. So. Alright. We are back. We are live. Let's get this show on the road.
So I mapped out who I wanted to be in six different ways, and I'm going to touch on all six and give you the answers to who I want to be, and you will see how this will guide me in all the decisions that I make in this vlog. So number one is career, like who I want to be career wise. I mapped out who I wanted to be. Number one, I want to be a successful CEO. That's what I want to be. I want to be like one of them guys that's like on Forbes or whatever. Like, I want to be like a really successful CEO. Secondly, I want to be an influencer. Like, that's just one of them things that I've always wanted to do. Like, I always want to be like a content creator, an influencer. So like, you know, and that's part of the reason why I'm making this vlog too. It's a part of who I want to be. So those are the two things that I want to be career-wise. I want to be a big CEO and I want to be an influencer. You know, for everybody else, it may be different, like, you know, as far as who they want to be, but that's who I want to be career-wise. Now, how I'm going to go about doing this. Now, me, when I work on something, I always map out what I want to do, and I map out the first step when it comes to like changing things like personally about who I am. And the reason why I do that is because oftentimes I feel like people will go in and they'll try to like talk about all these things they want to change themselves or like do better, and then they'll overload themselves with a bunch of different things they need to do, and then they'll end up feeling overloaded and not staying consistent on whatever it is that they were trying to do. So anytime I map out something that I want to do, I always just map out the first step and then work on that first step and then go from there. So the first step as far as me being able to be like a big CEO is, I need to promote my business every day. So like, one thing that I got in the habit of, I would make a lot of content, but I would make a lot of content that wasn't selling anything, but I wouldn't make content that was actually selling stuff. So a lot of times people will be seeing all this great content, but then they wouldn't even know what business I had or like what business I was selling until I keep having to explain. And that was because I wasn't promoting myself daily. I was making a lot of content, but I wasn't promoting myself. And also another reason behind why I chose this as far as like my first step as being a big CEO was my past business, I really didn't like it. So like I wasn't promoting it. You know what I'm saying? So right now I'm building a promoting worthy business. You know what I'm saying? So that's why, you know, this is my first step to being a major CEO, is to simply like promote my business every day in some way, while still making content, but just promoting my business every day. Now, secondly, if I want to be an influencer, I need to be making content every single day. So my goal is to make one video every day, no matter if it's good or bad. I'm gonna just give my all to that video, but I'm making one video every single day. That's gonna be a part of me being able to be an influencer. I have to make content, so you know, that's my thing, one video per day. Now, the second thing that I wanted to touch on was health. So I believe like health is wealth. Like whatever, you know, if you're not yourself health-wise, then you know, anything that you're trying to do outside of the health just affects literally everything. Also, I feel like in order for me to be a CEO, like I need to be at optimal health. And I feel like if you're not disciplined enough to handle like yourself, like health-wise, image-wise, like what makes you think that you can run like a business? You know what I'm saying? And you just feel sloppy, like you feel undisciplined. You know what I'm saying? So I want to be at optimal health. As far as the things that I want to do within my health, number one, I want to have like stable blood sugar, and I want to be really consistent with this. So if you all may or may not know, I'm a diabetic. So I've been diabetic since like the eighth grade. Actually, I have something on my arm right now. And this little thing right here, people often ask me like what this is on my arm. Now this thing right here, it checks my blood sugar, like, and all I gotta do is kind of like scan it in a sense, and it checks my blood sugar. It's really cool. It's like a really cool thing to have. And so like I'm a diabetic, so I wanna have like stable blood sugar, and that's a part of me like standing optimal health, so I can be that CEO that I wanna be, and just discipline like overall. You know what I'm saying? So and you know, that's something, a fun fact that I wanted to put out there. And I was kind of weary of like letting people know if I was a diabetic, because I didn't want me like chasing after health goals for it to seem like, oh, you only chasing after a health goal because you're a diabetic, I don't need to do that. So I was always kind of like weary of like whether I should tell people about that type of stuff. But you know, I just want to be transparent to y'all, and you know, really, I don't know, just really want to be transparent to y'all, and like just let y'all know like what I'm really working with, I'm really working through every day of my life. So you know, I want to have like stable blood sugar. So the second thing that I want to do like health-wise is I want a flat stomach, yo. Like I'm not even trying to get the six pack, none of that. Like I literally just want a flat stomach, yo. Like literally, and I just like, come on, man. And then after that, I'll work on six pack and stuff like that. But I literally just want a flat stomach, yo. Literally. That's it. And it sounds funny, you probably watch this, but I mean, it's real. Like that's what I want, like health wise. So that's the second thing that I want. So step one on how I'm gonna be able to do this. So if I want stable blood sugar, number one, as far as when you are diabetic, like you can't eat as many carbs as a regular person would eat. I mean, you can eat whatever you want, technically. But you can't eat whatever you want, technically. So like you have to like monitor the amount of carbs that you eat. So what I want to do is I want to drop my carb level to about 175 carbs per day, and that's it. So like that's what I want to do, and I'm gonna work on that daily. So only eating 175 carbs per day, you know, I'm gonna have to track my carbs and stuff like that, but that's what I want to do, like health wise to, you know. And that's my first step, is only eating 175 carbs per day. So, you know, that's that there. Now, as far as me getting this flat stomach, I need to exercise 3 to 4 times per week. So, I mean, usually I'm going on runs and stuff like that, but I mean, like, I don't know, man. I just need to exercise 3 to 4 times per week. That's my first step, and I'm going to work on that daily. And, you know, I'm just taking it day by day, work on that daily. And 3 is family. Like, who do you want to be as a family man or a family woman? It's like, who do you want to be in that aspect? So me, like, who I want to be as a relative, I want to be, like, a resource to people, and I want to be a mentor to people. So, like, mind you, like, my family, like, we ain't have, like, much, you know what I'm saying? So, like, me being successful and stuff like that is really a lot. Like, it really means a lot to me to be able to be that resource in the family, you know what I'm saying? Like, and what I mean by resource, I don't only mean, like, money. I mean, like, money, knowledge, you know what I'm saying? Like, I want to be, like, a resource and a mentor, like, to people in my family. You know what I'm saying? Because I want to duplicate me. I want to duplicate where I'm going in my life. So, like, you know, I want to, you know, that's what I want to do. I want to be a resource and a mentor to people in my family. Now, step one of how I'm going to be able to do this is, like, I just want to make sure, number one, that I'm building good relationships with people in my family. I'm not saying that we don't, but I feel like I don't talk enough to, like, people, you know, my family members. So, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to check in with my family members, like, every 2 weeks. Like, just check in. Hey, what's up? What you doing? What you need? You know what I'm saying? Like, just really just checking in, seeing what's up. You know what I'm saying? And that stuff really means a lot, believe it or not, man. Like, family is so important. Whether people realize it or not, people may say what they want to say. But I personally believe, like, family is really important. Because if nobody got your back, you know, family gonna have your back. You know what I'm saying? And that's what I believe, no matter what anybody say. So, you know, that's how I'm gonna work on that. It's like checking in with my family, like, every 2 weeks. I just said it like that. And so the next thing is, like, who do I want to be, like, lifestyle money wise and people make it this mixed up with, like, career and money lifestyle. But I mean, I can be a big CEO, but my money and lifestyle, maybe I want to give all of my money away. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I'm getting, like, laser focused on what I want in my life, you know, as far as lifestyle and stuff like that, money lifestyle. So my thing that I want is, like, number one, I want a freedom of location lifestyle. I want to be able to, like, pretty much work from anywhere for the most part. You know what I'm saying? So, like, freedom to travel, freedom to move. I don't want to be stuck, like, in my business. I don't want to be stuck to one location. That's just not what I want right now at this point in my life. So, like, I want that. Next thing is freedom lifestyle. I want a new car. Like, I want to say a BMW, but I'm starting to move, be more of a Mercedes person. But, like, I want that. And as far as, like, house, I want, like, a modern, like, mansion. Like, that's what I always wanted. Like, I'm gonna even show y'all a photo of this. Like, and I've been in plenty of them, but, like, I want one for myself. Like, I want, like, a modern mansion. Like, my house gotta look like a fucking spaceship, dude. Like, literally, you gotta look like a fucking spaceship. And I'm gonna just, I don't even wanna go into too in detail with it, because I could talk forever about how I want my house to be. But, like, lifestyle, money-wise, like, those are 3 things that I want. Like, freedom of location, right now, I want a new car. And just, like, long-term speaking, I want a modern mansion. Not a modern house, a modern, like, mansion. My shit needs to look like a fucking spaceship. Like, no lie, that's what I want. Now, in order for me to do this, step one, pretty simple. If I can't buy it 3 times, don't buy it. So if something costs $1,000, right? And I can't buy that, and I can't afford to buy that $1,000 thing 3 times, I'm not gonna buy it. Like, I'm literally not gonna buy it. If it's $100, I can't afford it. And if I can't afford to buy it 3 times, I'm not gonna buy it. And then, like, just having this mindset is gonna set me up to get this lifestyle and money goals as far as who I want to be. It's going to set me up to be able to achieve that. So, like, if I can't buy it 3 times, I'm not buying it. Plain and simple. Now, number 5, insecurities. So this is one thing that a lot of people don't really want to touch on, and don't really want to address because they may be insecure. But I feel like when you address your insecurities, it makes you better in business. You know what I'm saying? Overall, I feel like that's what it's doing. It'll make you better in business, your work life, whatever. And just you just feel better about yourself. So like, one thing that I'm really insecure about is like, I'm like afraid to like talk to women that I actually want to talk to. So like, not women like in general, but like women that I actually am really interested in, and like women that I actually like want, like women that I like actually want to talk to. You know what I'm saying? So like me, for example, if I see like a girl in the store, and I'm like, damn, like she look like amazing, beautiful, right? Like it's like you. To all my dudes watching this or listening to this, you know exactly what I'm talking about. So like, if I see him in the store or something or whatever, and it's like my ideal female that I would really want to really want to talk to, I be want to say something, but then I don't like say anything, and then I'm like beating myself up in the fucking head because like, well, damn, why didn't I say something? And I'm like beating myself up in the head, and like where this insecurity has gotten me is like, I end up with a lot of females that I'm not fully interested in, and like some of them be beautiful, but their personality, like just stuff about them, I'm just like not fully there with, you know, there with the men. Or it's just like my ideal female is not them, and I keep running into the same type of girl because I'm too afraid to like talk to the women that I really want. You know what I'm saying? So like, and I feel like if I can't sell myself to a female that I really want, how can I sell to like customers? You know what I'm saying? Like, that's like the ultimate salesmanship. Like, if you're really good at selling yourself to like females and whatever. So like, like I don't know. In my opinion, like if I can't do that, it's like how can I sell myself to you know, to anybody else? So like, I don't know. So like, that's one thing that I'm like insecure about, is like my fear of like being said no to when it comes to like talking to females and stuff like that. Like, so even if I feel like, I don't know, that's just like my, and not even just talking to females, like I said, just talking to the females that I actually want. You know what I'm saying? So like, that's the thing. Talking to females that I actually want. So step one of how I'm gonna fix this is, anytime I see a female in public that I feel like damn, like that's my ideal, you know what I'm saying? Even if I feel like she's gonna like turn me down or whatever, I'm gonna still go and say something. I'm still gonna like go and talk to her or whatever. And like, I feel like every time I've actually done this though, it's been very rare that I've actually been turned down. So like, I don't know, it's just like that, it's like that scaredness or like insecurity of like being said no or like feeling stupid or whatever. But like every time that I go against the grain on how I feel about that, like it pretty much always works out well, and I end up with a really good girl. So like, like that's one thing that I want to address, like insecurity wise. It's like whatever you insecure about, like work on that daily. Like, you know, don't let that insecurity drive you to a place that you don't want to really be. So like, you know, that's something that, you know, I'm working on. Now that's who I want to be, like within myself. Now let's talk about what I want this business to be. Right now, so obviously I want this to be $100,000 business. You know, this is a content series, so like that's number one. Secondly, I want to build a killer marketing team out of this entire business that I'm building. So my main goal, I mean, it's obviously to add value to customers and stuff like that, but my long-term gameplay with this is I'm gonna get a killer ass marketing team. You know what I'm saying? So like, this entire agency that I'm building, I'm really gonna be using this stuff for myself, for like future brands that I make, you know, that I create after this. You know what I'm saying? And this entire agency is just proving that they're good at what they do. And I'm kind of just like, as allowing businesses and other entrepreneurs or whatever to borrow my marketing team. You know what I'm saying? It's like that's, you know, I pretty much, number two, I just want to build a killer marketing team. And then number three, I want to build a massive amount of relationships out of this business. So I really want to expand my network. You know what I'm saying? And just pretty much like, I don't know what other way to explain this. Build massive amounts of relationships, get connected with a lot of different types of people. That's what I really want to get out of this content series and out of this business, as well as just connecting with a mass amount of people. Step one of how I'm going to be able to accomplish this is the obvious. Stay disciplined, stay consistent on who I want to be in this list, and then I'll be able to have this accomplishment when it comes to my business. Like, all together, that's a breakdown of who I want to be career-wise, money-wise, family-wise, health-wise, and security-wise, and business-wise. You know what I'm saying? So that's all in whole who I want to be, and I feel like this is a good place to start, like, with this vlog, because I feel like a lot of people don't really get laser focused on who they actually want to be before they try to jump into a business. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like, and I'm really happy that guy Patrick Bay David got me onto this mindset, because I've applied this in different things and aspects of what I was doing in the past, and it worked. You know what I'm saying? But I feel like now that I'm on the path to actually doing something I'm happy about doing, I'm happy about promoting and stuff like that, I feel like this will really help me out and really get me, like, to the next level. So really just getting laser focused on who I want to be. So, like, question to you, if you're watching this video or you listen to this in the podcast format, is map out who you want to be. Like, who do you want to be? And that's, like, a very good question. A lot of people can't answer that instantly. You know what I'm saying? Because, like I said, I already had these answers, like, mapped out. It took me, like, a couple of hours to really, like, map this out before I record this extra part of this vlog. But, like, just map out, like, who, man, like, who do you want to be? Like, pretty much map out what shit makes you feel like a fucking loser. You know what I'm saying? Like, map out all of that stuff and map out a game plan of how you can attack that and confront that and work towards who you want to actually be. So, you know, that's episode one of this vlog. You know what I'm saying? And episode two, you know, we don't get busy, you know, all the way in the business. But this is, like, the most important, in my opinion, the most important portion of this vlog, because if I don't have this together, nothing in this business will work. So yeah, so that's that. And I think I'm gonna title this episode, like I said, who do you want to be? And, you know, that's pretty much that. So, guys, you know, I hope you all enjoyed this episode one of this vlog, you know, just really discovering who you want to be. And, you know, episode two is gonna come out on Friday. I'm gonna keep y'all updated on everything. I may release a couple little YouTube videos in between, but you know, episode two is gonna come on, definitely gonna come out on Friday. And we're gonna pretty much do everything from there. So make sure y'all comment, you know, if y'all like this video or not. You know what I'm saying? You know, hopefully y'all did. Subscribe, like, all the different stuff. And I appreciate you for watching this vlog. And I promise you, it's gonna help you accomplish whatever you're trying to accomplish in your life once we get to the end of this thing. So thank you once again, and I will see you on Friday. Peace.